Welcome to Big Data Pedia. Today we are going to discuss looping statements in Python programming. In Python programming, we have two types of statement. Looping statement is available. One is for, another one is while. So we will going to see with some hands-on in this looping statements now. I just already opened. I mentioned something. So what is mean by loop? Loop is a control flow statement for specifying iteration, which allow the code to be executed repeatedly until the condition satisfied. That is called looping. In this looping, we can use for loop as well while loop. So the difference between for loop and while loop. So for loop will follow only with numerical ranges, and for loop can possible with for loop else operations. So this else condition will be available only in Python to compare with other programming languages. And next, while loop. While loop, not only for numerical, we can follow with non-numerical values as well. So once the condition satisfied, both will become out. And while loop, we have do while with respect to of true and if statement conditions. So directly we cannot use do while, but we can achieve that same via true and if else statements. And while also can possible with else statements. Now we can go with little hands up, then you can clearly understand. So first we will start from for loop. Now I just declare one variable as I. In range function, I just mentioned some values. So if you are initiating with any for loop variable, that will start from zero index. I just mentioned in comment. And in for loop we are providing numerical values. So print I, simply I just mentioned. Now you can see the output. So it will be start from 0 until the condition satisfied, it's going to be execute. If you are using the range values, whatever you will be provided, that value minus 1 will be considered and it will be executed. Once the value will be reached to this value, the function will not be continued. Let's see the same example now with else operations. So say print I as a lost value. Value of I. After condition satisfied, not satisfied. So I just declare the I value again. So you can see the value will be iterated while it's moving to the fifth value, it will not be matched, directly it comes and print the values. Next we are going to see in while loop now. So while we will go with numerical first, then we will come with non-numerical values. So I just declare another variable j equal to 0 while j matching, sorry, less than 5. If j is less than 5, then print it. Just printing the j value. And again I am going to increase j with incremental. In for loop you will not be using this incremental, because directly it will be following with the range values and continuous iteration will be happen. But while loop you will be using with iterations. So now we can see output. So now it will be going to check 0 and continuously it will be incremented one by one and getting the output. So fifth less than 5 will not be matched, so it will not be providing the output here. This is for numerical. next we can see better, we can see with else part as well here. Print as nothing. Okay, four time it's iterated, fifth time it's showing us nothing value. Next we'll go with non-numerical value now. So I just declared non-numerical value as a password. I'm going to use it now. I just requesting the password here as a with console inputs. So input function will be used for console inputs. Print enter your password. And now I'm going to check the conditions, while condition operator, while password not equal to big data pedia, so it will make loopings. So until this condition match with this value, it will be requesting again. So here I'm asking the same inputs. Like this. So if it is not matched, whatever the first value will be provided, it is not matched, so it will be coming here internally. Condition will be true because the value will not be matched, whatever will be provided. If value will be matched, it will not be continue here, it just come out. So it will be followed with false statement, not equal to operations. Okay, now we can see I just provide only big data. It will not be matched, so it's asking for password again because condition not matched. Then it will come for inside iteration operation. Now I'm providing big data pedia with a small letter of d. Here I just mentioned as a caps d, here I just mentioned as a small d value. So now also the value will not be matched. Now I just copy the value and paste here, so exactly this value will be appeared here. Now I can enter. Now it just come out from input function. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.